Welcome! In this tutorial, you'll learn how to install and configure the iiQKA Conveyor Tech Option Package in iiQWorks.Sim. Let's start by opening iiQWorks Cockpit. To access the software repository, move your mouse over the left border of the cockpit window and click on the icon labeled SWR. Now, let's install the iiQKA Conveyor Tech Option Package. On the right side of the software repository, click the small arrow next to the package name. From the drop-down menu, select Install. This will install the KUKA option package directly into iiQWorks.Sim. Once you've selected Install, switch to iiQWorks.Sim and approve the installation when prompted. Please note, iiQWorks.Sim will need to restart to complete the installation. After the restart, let's set up a layout. From the ECAT, add a robot and a robot tool to your scene. I will use a KR10R1102 and place it in the origin of the simulation. In addition to that, I will add a measuring tip for my models. You can use any other tool depending on your real setup. Next, go to the ECAT, find the Option Packages folder and there the iiQKA Conveyor Tech and add a conveyor. You can choose either a linear or circular conveyor. Position the conveyor as desired and adapt the width, height and length depending on your own setup. Now, from the Public Models section, attach a creator and a conveyor sensor to the conveyor using the Manipulation Mode Plug-and-Play PNP. Make sure to configure a valid part in the conveyor's properties. I will adapt the size of the creator and change the created product shape to pyramids and their height to 100 mm. Also, ensure that the conveyor sensor is correctly attached to the conveyor. I will position the sensor at exactly 600 mm from the origin of the conveyor. All these settings can vary depending on your real layout and setup. Next, let's add the option package to the robot. Click on the robot in your layout. In the component properties, navigate to the Option Package Configuration section. Select iiQKA Conveyor Tech from the available options and click the plus symbol to add it to the robot. A confirmation window will appear. Click OK to confirm the modification. If you encounter any conflicts with other option packages or their versions, make sure to download the correct ones from the software repository. Now, let's connect the conveyor and robot using interfaces. Click on Interfaces in the toolbar. Select the conveyor and connect the robot tracking interface to one of the 5 available robot interfaces. A new window will open. Here, confirm the tracking index, conveyor type, and position interface. In the Position Interface section, you can choose between the resolver on the RDC or the field bus configuration. Let's continue by configuring the RDC if you selected it as your position interface. After selecting the RDC, the Project Analyzer will notify you that your standard configuration is missing a position tracker. Click on Open Proposal dialog. A new configuration proposal window will open. In the updated state, a position tracker will be automatically added. Click OK to proceed, or adapt the configuration to match your real hardware setup. To validate the configuration, go to the Drive Configuration tab. You should now see the position tracker listed. Next, let's activate the fast measurement input. Click on the robot in your layout. In the Component Properties, go to the Controller tab. Activate the checkbox labeled Fast Measurement Input. Now, let's connect the sensor to the robot's fast measurement signal. Open the Signals tab. Connect the fast measurement signal from the robot to the sensor Boolean signal of the conveyor sensor. Now let's configure the conveyor. Click on the conveyor and go to the Conveyor Tech tab. Select the link tracking robot. Then, click on the small gear icon labeled Tracking Settings to open the detailed configuration window. Click on Move Conveyor Origin to reposition the origin in the 3D layout. Make sure that the tracking frame is aligned with the offset of the conveyor sensor. In my case, it's exactly 600 mm. Let's now adapt the further configuration of the conveyor behavior. Click on the conveyor and go back to the Conveyor Tech tab. Next, adapt the work area of the conveyor. You can adjust the start and end of the work area, the synchronization area, and the alarm distance depending on your application. You can select the stop strategy that best fits your application. Next, you can adjust the weight cancellation or distance trigger settings. You can also fine-tune the motion parameters to match your process requirements. Now, let's select the workpiece. In my case, the conveyor creator generates 100 by 100 by 100 millimeter pyramids, so I will swiftly recreate one from the basic shapes in the ECAD. You can import a dummy CAG part depending on your setup. In the offline programming assistance, select the workpiece in the 3D scene using the yellow cube icon or the drop-down menu. Tick the checkbox workpiece visible to visualize the part on the conveyor. This helps with offline programming. With the offset component option, you can fine-tune the position of the part based on the scene distance. Use the scene distance slider to move the workpiece along the conveyor. This will help you when programming points around the part. I will leave the part at the beginning of the work area to teach a pick position. And that's it! You've now completed the full configuration of the iiQKA Conveyor Tech Option Package in iiQWorks.Sim. Let's now move on to robot programming with iiQKA Conveyor Tech. Click on the robot and go to the Program tab. In the Program view, right-click and create two new programs. Name them, for example, CT Main and CT Run. Right-click on CT Main and select Show to make it the active program. Now, let's add a CT init statement to CT Main. You can find it in the Programming pane under the Conveyor Tech drop-down menu. This menu is only visible if the option package is installed. Next, adapt CT Main to your use case. For example, you can add a loop and a wait position. Important, every position must be a splin or PTP classic motion. Do not use spline motions like splin or SPTP. Now, let's add a CT run statement in CT main. From the Conveyor Tech drop-down menu, insert a CT run statement. Click on the statement CT run program semicolon program and look at the statement properties on the right. Replace semicolon program with the CT run program you created earlier. Now switch to the CT run program. Delete the default home positions and the default initialization. Add a CT tracking on statement from the Conveyor Tech drop-down menu. In the statement properties, select the conveyor you configured earlier. In the scene, select the desired part. You can also adjust the work area offset or return motion depending on your setup. Now add your program logic between CT tracking on and CT tracking off. For example, add a linear motion to a pick position and a wait statement of 2 seconds. And make sure to select the base, conveyor scene, if the robot should synchronize its motion with the moving part. Add a wait for statement to define the time the robot should follow the movement of the part. Again, make sure all positions are LIN classic motion. No PTP or spline motions are allowed. Finally, add a CT tracking off statement at the end of the CT run program. And that completes the robot programming for iiQKA Conveyor Tech. We can now run the program using both the RCS and the VRC. Let's begin by selecting the conveyor in the layout. In the Conveyor Tech properties, deactivate the option called Workpiece Visible. This hides the part from the 3D view that helped us during offline programming. Now we're ready to run the program. First, we'll use the robot controller simulation. Make sure the CT main program is selected. When we start the simulation, the robot will wait in the wait position until the first part reaches the work area. Once the part arrives, the robot synchronizes with its movement and follows it for 2 seconds. You can observe this behavior in the output window, where it says, "Wait 2 seconds." Next, let's switch to the virtual robot controller. This allows us to simulate the robot exactly as it would behave in the real world using iiQKA OS 2. To do that, go to the execution mode settings and select Virtual Robot Controller. I already have an instance called CT Demo prepared on my local host, so I'll choose that. Once the switch is complete, run the program again. You'll see the same behavior. The robot waits, synchronizes with the part, and follows it for 2 seconds. This confirms that the logic works both in simulation and in virtual commissioning. Congratulations to this nice result! Everything you configured, programmed, simulated with the RCS, and validated with the VRC with the iiQKA Conveyor Tech Option Package in iiQWorks.Sim will behave the same way on a physical robot.
Thanks for tuning in. We appreciate your support. Make sure to subscribe the KUKA channel for the latest updates and tutorials. For hands-on experience, check out the KUKA College. Until next time, and keep learning and simulating.
Making automation easier.